This lecture is a continuation of my previous lecture on NP completeness. So, regarding NP completeness, so far we have seen some of the problems and we have established that they are NP complete, and here we are demonstrating a procedure to establish a problem NP complete wherever it is. And I have initiated a discussion and introduced a problem on satisfiability regarding satisfiability of Boolean formulae. So, I had mentioned that this is the first problem which was proved that it is NP complete, Boolean satisfiability. The problem states that, a general problem that given a Boolean formula, whether it is satisfiable. So, this is the problem, and Stephen Cook, he has established that it is NP complete sometime around 1971, and for which he has received the prestigious Turing Award. So, in this, as a classroom lecture, I started giving certain reductions and observed some of the problems are NP complete. And the first problem, of course, in these lectures we have observed that a quantitative non-deterministic analog of analogous problem to halting problem. That means, here what is given, a non-deterministic Turing machine will be given to you and an input string. So, whether m halts on w within a given number of steps. So, the version of halting problem and comparing to this, it is a non-deterministic version. Of course, we give some time parameter also, that means within this many steps whether your non-deterministic machine halts or not. So, we have observed that it is NP complete, and we have observed that certain variants of these problems are also NP complete, like we have discussed in case of undecidability. And further, tiling problem, we have observed that it was undecidable, we have seen that. And a bounded tiling problem, this is again a quantitative version, so to say. So, tiling problem, so called bounded tiling problem, that means this time you have to tile a fixed space, so a finite space, say for example, of size each side S. So, S by S tiling, a tiling system. This is a bounded tiling problem. So, whether there is a tiling. So, given a tiling system, whether there is a tiling to to tile the region of size S, that means S by S tiling. So, we have shown that it is NP complete by reducing one of these problems, the first problem that we have shown in polynomial time to this bounded tiling problem. So, at that point, in that lecture, I have of course, introduced the Boolean satisfiability problem also. However, I will just recap what is satisfiability problem. So, here the domain is a Boolean formulae. The Boolean formulae over a set of variables is essentially defined recursively using these two rules. So, each variable is a formula, so called atomic formula, and then negation of a formula and or so called the disjunction of two formulas is a formula, and conjunction of two formulas is also a formula. And then a formula is said to be satisfiable if there is a truth assignment which gives truth value true to the formula. So, that is the satisfiability problem. And now, the variant that we consider for the general satisfiability problem is a formula which is given in conjective normal form, whether it is satisfiable, that we consider. So, and the problem I am writing it as SAT, the satisfiability problem. Okay. And the theorem, Cook's theorem states that satisfiability problem SAT is NP complete, for which I ask you to observe that SAT is in NP. And in this lecture, now we will observe that it is NP hard. What I am going to do here, of course, I am in the sequence. So, N naught we have shown it is NP complete, and then I have reduced N naught to N 1, a variant of that problem, and then N 1 I have reduced to T, the bounded tiling problem, to show that bounded tiling problem is NP complete. Now, what I will do, I will take bounded tiling problem, the NP complete problem, and reduce the T to the satisfiability problem set. So, this is the chain that I have considered in these lectures. So, what? So, this is what I said, the T less than or equal to P set will show to show that this set is NP hard. So, what I have to do for that purpose? A given a tiling system D and a number S, I have to construct a Boolean formula. I may write F D, because this formula is based on the given system D, such that D has an S by S tiling if and only if this F D is satisfiable. This is what is essentially the condition for the reduction. Okay. So, given say D naught H V, the tiling system with D finite set of tiles with names say T naught, D 1 and so on, D k, and a number S, we construct a Boolean formula F D, and as the problem we have stated will be given in a conjective normal form. So, I construct a formula in its conjective normal form directly. So, that means essentially I have to consider conjunction of disjunction of laterals. So, I give you what are the disjunction of laterals using the given tiling system, and then all this put together, that means conjunction of all this disjunction of laterals will be the formula F D that I am going to construct. And this F D, we have to observe the corresponding to F D, I have to check this correspondence. Now, let me just give you the philosophy like of this construction. Okay. What do I do? See, what is the correspondence I should have? I should construct a formula F D. So, this is conjunction of some disjunction of some laterals. So, here you will have some laterals say L 1 and so on, L 2 and so on. So, some disjunctions, right. So, this kind of formula we will be constructing, and the correspondence is given tiling system, if it is having an S by S tiling, then this formula should be satisfiable and vice versa. So, that kind of correspondence we have to get. So, what I will do here in this tiling system, each tile corresponding to each tile, I mean fixing at a particular place, we will give a notion of lateral here, I mean variable first I will look at, such a way that whenever I have a tiling here, the formula is satisfiable and vice versa. So, for which, what do we consider? You know, fixing a tile here is the process of tiling, but the position, say for example, the corner say m n position, if I am fixing a tile, then I may that is the intention I will take and consider the variables with say x m n d, we will consider a variable for the Boolean formulae, which essentially represents in the position m n, we could fix the tile d in a tiling. So, with this intention we consider this kind of variables, and now if that is the intention, this variable x m n d will give truth value true. I mean fixing d in m n position, that means this variable the for this atomic formula we give the truth value true if in the m n position we fix the tile d. If you are not fixing the tile d in m n position, then of course, it should receive truth value false. So, that kind of intention we consider. So, we construct a Boolean formula F D by considering the atomic statement variables x m n d for each 0 less than or equal to m n less than s, because when we are tiling the space of size s by s, all the points m n which we will consider with less than s and d in d. So, what is the statement variable set? This x, x m n d with this property. Now, what are all the disjunctions that I am going to consider? in the form for the formula f d. Okay. Now, you look at the position m n, okay. If this has a tiling f from, let me write 0 to s minus 1 cross 0 to s minus 1. To d, if this is the function tiling, if you have, what is the meaning of that? Each position should receive a tile, okay? Each position m n position should receive a tile, and since this is a function, this should receive exactly one tile, okay? And moreover, this tiling has to satisfy some of the what are the horizontal and vertical constraints it satisfies. If you want to fix a tile here, this and this should satisfy the vertical constraints, and similarly, if you want to fix a tile horizontally side by side, then the concerning properties, horizontal constraints whatever are given, need to be satisfied. This is what is tiling. Now, exactly the same philosophy we translate and prepare and construct this formula f d. Okay? So, for that purpose, first you look at what is the meaning a tile goes to this position. That means, among the tiles given to you d naught, d 1, d k, at least one tile should go here. That is the first point, and then each position should receive exactly one tile, because you cannot fix two tiles here, right. So, since it is a function, if that has to be well defined in the in a element in the domain. See, for example, for the element m n, if you are fixing say some d and d dash, then you know d should be equal to d dash, because at each position you can fix only one tile. So, this relation, because fixing at least one tile is important, and then to say this is a function, we require this well definedness property, because f of m n equal to d and f of m n equal to d dash, then this d should be equal to d dash. This is the thing that we will ascertain, that f, the assignment is a function, and moreover, in the first position you require the d naught to be fixed, and the whatever the tiling that you give, whatever the function f you give, it has to satisfy vertical and horizontal constraints. So, all these things sort of need to be translated as Boolean formula to construct f d, and if the correspondence is clear, then you can easily observe that this f d is satisfiable if and only if you know you will have a tiling to this square of size s by s. All right. So, let us look at the disjunctions, what do we give here. For each m n less than s, I consider this disjunction. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? X m n d naught, that means m n position would receive d naught or d 1 or d 2. So, that is how I will read. The intention of x m n d I had already stated. The intention of the variable x m n d that we are considering, in the position m n position would receive a tile named d. Okay? So, by considering this kind of conjunction, disjunction, so this formula will be true if at least one of them should be true, right. So, and therefore, if one of them is given truth value true, so what our intention is, that particular, say for example, if this formula is true, that means x m n d I sum I, we have to give truth value true. Otherwise, you know, if all of them are false, this disjunction cannot be true, right. So, if x m n d is receiving truth value true, some truth assignment t gives truth value true, 1 or 0 whatever you write t. Okay. So, then what is the intention? In the m n position, I have received a tile d I, all right. So, that is essentially captured by this formula. And in the second place, as I mentioned, this has to be, you know, unique tile need to be received. What is the meaning of that? In m n position, if I have received a tile d, then, so that is represented by x m n d, then in the m n position, there should not be any other tile d dash, where d different from d dash, right. So, this is the condition for the well definedness of your tiling. So, now if you look at this x m n d arrow, x m n d dash for d different from d dash, all right. So, this can be now x m n d implies x m n d dash. So, this formula of course, is equivalent to negation of I am writing with bar the negation. So, x m n d bar r. So, this should not be received, right. So, this cannot receive x cannot receive d, any other tile d dash. So, that means negation of this variable. So, that means x m n d dash. So, if so, what is the meaning of the statement? M n position, if there is a tile, if you are fixing d in m n position, then m n position cannot receive any other tile d dash. So, cannot receive means negation of this variable. So, you know this arrow, this is equivalent to this. Now, clearly this is in a this is a disjunction, right, disjunction of laterals. So, this formula we consider for each m and n less than s and different from d dash. This is the second clause, disjunction of laterals that we considered. And the third point is in 0 0 position d naught should be there. So, I will consider this also in the formula. Okay? This is only one lateral I have considered, therefore, it is a disjunction of laterals. So, I will consider this also. And then you look at, so horizontal constraints need to be satisfied. So, horizontal constraints are in H. So, that means if you take a pair d and d dash in H, then only you know you can fix the tiles side by side, horizontal constraints, right. So, this is the position m n and this is the position m plus 1 n. And now, if you take two different tiles which are not satisfying the horizontal constraints, if you take two tiles d and d dash which is not satisfying horizontal constraints, that means this is in d square minus h, then they cannot be fixed side by side. What is the meaning of that? If d is fixed at the position m n, that means x m n d, then you cannot fix d dash in this position m plus 1 n position, right. So, that means you cannot fix, that means d dash cannot be fixed in m n, that means negation of this. So, this again using this equivalence p arrow q, the formula is equivalent to negation p r q. Of course, I am writing here p bar r q, all right. So, I will consider this clause, I mean this disjunction of laterals. Now, you look at, you take any pair of tiles d and d dash which are not satisfying horizontal constraint, they cannot be put horizontally side by side. This formula can be written as disjunction of these laterals. And now, since m is, I am taking this way, m plus 1 horizontal constraints I am looking for. So, m is less than s minus 1 and n can be anything less than s. Okay. Similarly, we can talk about a pair satisfying you know vertical constraints can only be fixed there. So, that means you take any two tiles which are not satisfying vertical constraints, I will consider concerning disjunction of laterals this way. This also I will take part of the formula. And now, you look at how many clauses I have considered. I mean what I mean a clause, it is a disjunction of laterals. Okay. How many clauses that we are considering here? You look at. So, for each position m n, I am considering this disjunction of laterals, this clause I am considering. So, how many such? For each position 1 we are considering, therefore, there are you know s minus s by s tiling. For s by s tiling each position need to be fixed. So, the finite number of these clauses that disjunction of laterals we are considering. Okay. So, for each position, so let me write this formula f d. So, for f d what we are going to consider, for f d is now the clauses for each position m n. So, d naught r x m n d 1 and so on x m n d k. So, this kind of disjunctions I consider for each position. That means, I may put, so if you want to take m n to be 0 0 here, then 0 1 0 2 and so on, 0 s minus 1, likewise I have to consider, and similarly all the entire square. So this I may simply write it as m comma n less than s. Okay. So this is the formula that we have considered, which says that it receives at least one of the tiles, each position receives at least one of the tile. And now you look at this, receives exactly one tile. So how many such for every pair d different from d dash? That means you see here how many you have, k tiles you have. So that means total k square tiles, and in this k square k of them are equal, right? Pairs d and d will come also in this, and therefore so k square minus k for this many pairs in this, and for each position mn I will consider this clause disjunction of laterals. All right. So again there are finitely many, so all these things need to be written down here. All right. So if I write like this, so x mn d or x mn d dash, this for which mn less than s and d different from d dash. So essentially here finitely many clauses I am writing, but I am writing it in a single this thing. And the next case, this clause also we wanted to consider, because in 0 0 position we have to put only d naught, so that is this guy, and the clauses concerning horizontal constraints and the clauses concerning vertical constraints. So this is what is FD I want to consider. Now you look at whether this is clear or not. The given a tiling system D, now we have considered a set of variables with the names x, m and d, with the intention that the tile D will go to the position m n. And to have a tiling, we have to have an assignment of at least one tile in each position, and that is one which is represented by this clauses, is a set of finite number of clauses here, and then it exactly receives only one tile to make this as a function. And then 0 0 should receive the tile d naught, with this intention we have introduced this clause, and corresponding to horizontal constraints, so we have the clauses here. So many finitely many clauses, they are to be put here. And similarly concerning this vertical constraints, we are considering this. Now with this intention, once I have constructed the formula FD, you can clearly verify that whenever you have a tiling, SVS tiling in the tiling system D, I can always see that there is a truth assignment which satisfies the formula FD, and vice versa. I will give you here, okay, how this can be shown. Suppose D has an SVS tiling, say F. Now define the truth assignment T from x to 0 1, because the truth assignment you have to give from the set of variables to 0 1, and you have to observe that this truth assignment, you know. So how do, when you have a SVS tiling F, I have to say that this formula is satisfiable. So I have to give a truth assignment which satisfies the given formula. How do I define that? The intention is very clear to you, right? So from that, the truth assignment should be defined this way. So the variable x, m and d will be given truth value 1 whenever you fix the tile d in the m n position. So that is, if f m n equal to d, if you are not fixing the tile d in m n position, then you simply put 0 for this. This is the truth assignment you take. Now you look at, to say FD is satisfiable, what I have to observe, each of these clauses written down here, each of the clauses written down here are satisfiable, right? For example, for the first clause, this disjunction of laterals, you see, now since it is tiling, each position should receive at least one tile, and therefore at least one of these variables should receive truth value true as per this assignment, all right? As per this assignment, okay, and therefore every clause which is defined in 1, every clause which is defined in 1 will be satisfied, okay. And then since f is a function, every position m n will receive exactly one tile, and therefore, each clause which is defined in 2 will also be satisfied using this truth assignment. And since d naught will be placed in the position 0 0, this clause will also be satisfied with the truth assignment given to you now. And since it is a tiling, for this tiling system it has to satisfy the horizontal constraint, and therefore, this clause also be satisfied. Now, okay, these things are a little bit looking straightforward, because this is essentially representing this. Now, this clause if you look at. Now, assume two tiles which are not satisfying horizontal constraint d and d dash, if they are fixed side by side, what is going to happen? They are fixed side by side. So, what is the meaning of that? In m n position, I have fixed this d, in m plus 1 n position, I have fixed d dash, but this is not in this. Suppose this happens, right? If both of them, suppose one of the clause is not satisfied, that means this is what is the situation. This should receive truth value 0, this also should receive truth value 0, right? If you assume that one of such clauses in this list is not satisfied, that means x m n d bar should receive, this should receive truth value 0, and also this should receive truth value 0. So, that means x m plus 1 n d dash, this also should receive, then only this is not satisfied, at least one of the clauses in this list, if it is not satisfied, this is the meaning of that. So, but this implies the truth assignment for the literal x m and d will be 1, and also truth assignment for the literal x m plus 1 and d dash is also 1. That means, what has happened here? So, this are fixed side by side, these are fixed side by side, but once you fix them side by side, you require this horizontal constraint need to be satisfied. But you see that we have considered d d dash, which is in d square minus h, which is not satisfying horizontal constraint, but if both of them are receiving truth value 0, then this situation is they will be fixed side by side, which is not possible, and hence every clause listed in this section 4, I call this section because there are so many clauses here, right. So, whatever is represented in this has to be satisfied. Similarly, every clause which is listed in this list 5 need to be satisfied, and thus you see all the clauses are satisfied. So, this clause here, every clause in this list is satisfied, this is satisfied, and this is also satisfied, and all these are satisfied, and hence f d is satisfied by the truth assignment t. Okay. Is that fine? So, what has happened now? If you assume there is a tiling for the tiling system D, we could give a truth assignment T which satisfies each and every clause or each and every the disjunction of laterals which is present in the formula F D is satisfied, and hence F D is satisfied. Therefore, we have got one direction, and in the converse also we have to observe. That means, whenever this formula F D is satisfied, I mean if it is satisfiable, that means if you have a truth assignment which satisfies this formula F D, we have to observe that the given system has an S by S tiling. Okay. So, further purpose, now conversely suppose a truth assignment T dash satisfies F D. Now, I will define a mapping G from this to this, because the tiling what I have to give, that is from this set, that means for each position I have to assign tile D. How do I define that? With this simple condition, this is what is our exactly our intention, right. So, whenever a variable is receiving truth value 1, then you fix the corresponding tile D in the position m n, and whenever this happens you fix it, and you will fix only when you know the variable receives truth value 1. Now, we have to observe that this is a tiling, G is a tiling. That means, what I have to look at? This G is a function, number 1, and number 2, that G satisfies horizontal and vertical constraints, and the what is called the tile D naught should go to the position 0, 0. All these things need to be verified via this function g. Now, let us look at, if there is a truth assignment which satisfies the formula f d, what is the meaning of that? All these clauses will be satisfied. So, now this clause, this disjunction of laterals is satisfied, that means this particular lateral which is present, only one lateral present in this, should receive truth value true. So, if this is receiving truth value true by this construction, you see 0 0 position should receive truth value should receive the tile D naught. So, that means G 0 0 will be D naught, all right. And of course, I have to observe that G is a function. Now, since I have already explained this intention of each clause, from which you can easily ascertain that this G is a function. Now, look at that again. Once again, I give an argument here. You see, every clause given in this should be satisfied. That means, at least one of the variable should receive truth value true. If at least one of them is receiving truth value true, that means the tile d I is going, at least one tile is going to the position m n, fine. And again, in the second list, what we have said, if you take two different tiles, they cannot go in the same position. At least one of them is receiving and this. By this, the function what we have defined here, because this is receiving truth value true, each one of them is receiving truth value true, means at least one of this should be true. If at least one of them should be true, that means you look at, if one is receiving this, then other cannot receive the tile. So, thus you can see that each of this clause will also be, since it is satisfied, you can see that function g is a function. And moreover, if these clauses are satisfied, the horizontal and vertical constraints will also be satisfied. Okay? You can make this argument carefully and observe that the function g in fact gives you an SVS tiling, and therefore, we have reduced in this method, we have reduced that the tiling problem is less than or equal to p set. All right. Now, I will give you some more information regarding the satisfiability problem. The satisfiability problem, the general problem which we have observed that it is NP complete. Now, to add some more in this list of NP complete problems, there are certain variants of this satisfiability problem that we can observe that they are also NP complete. You can reduce this problem satisfiability to those problems. I will just state some of them. Before that, first let me define the problem K set. What is this? Because you are given anyway a formula in CNF, conjective normal form. So, this time what I put a restriction is, given a Boolean formula in its CNF such that each disjunction, what are the sum that we have considered, right? Because in CNF, what do I have? This is conjunction of disjunction of laterals, right? So, each of these disjunctions will have at most k laterals. See, for example, if I take k is equal to 5, this bracket within this, the number of laterals which appear will be at most 5. Say, for example, L 1 or L 2 or L 3. Say, for example, here L 1, okay, say some L 2 or L 3 bar or L 4, L 5 bar. It is a 4 I have to consider. So, that way in a k set, the instance of this problem, the Boolean formula whatever that we are considering in conjective normal form, each of these disjunction will have at most k laterals, that is the instance of the problem. Now, given such a formula, the problem is whether or not the given formula is satisfiable. This is, it is a variant of this satisfiability problem. Now, if k is equal to 2, that means each of this disjunction, the clause which is present in the formula, will have at most 2 laterals. That means, you may have 1 lateral or you may have, you know, 2 laterals. So, that is what is essentially an instance of 2 set, the problem 2 set. We can observe that 2 set is in P. That means, you can have a polynomial time decider to settle this problem 2 set. So, So, till that point is fine. So, you can take this as an exercise to understand that, you know, the problem 2 sat is in P, that means you have to give a polynomial time decider a procedure. But what is with k sat? This is in P. Now, if you take that k greater than or equal to 3, in fact, let me just say this 3 sat. So, that means you are allowed to have the literal number of literals in a disjunction at most 3, okay? That is what is essentially 3 sat. 3 sat we can observe that this is NP complete. Okay? So, of course, in the routine manner like what we have observed for satisfiability problem, what we could have you could have observed that it is in NP that you have to observe, and then for NP complete you can reduce satisfiability problem to 3 sat. So, for this what you have to do? So, given a disjunction of k number of arbitrary number of laterals, a formula with an arbitrary number of laterals over the disjunctions, what you have to reduce? You have to give an equivalent formula. By giving an equivalent formula in which at most 3 literals are present, then you can reduce easily, and if you can do that within a polynomial time procedure, then you are through. So, what is that? So, you can observe that satisfiability can be reduced in polynomial time to 3 sat. So, for that what you would be doing, you take a formula f in sat, of course, a Boolean formula in which there is no restriction on the number of laterals in the given disjunctions. Okay? So, whatever is the arbitrary number of laterals that you can have in these disjunctions. So, here I am not worried the arbitrary number of laterals. What I have to construct? I have to construct a formula say f dash, given this I have to construct this, in which each disjunction will have at most 3 laterals. So, likewise you have to construct right a formula such that what is the condition this has to be satisfied? This f is in sat, that means whenever this formula is satisfiable, then this formula should also be satisfiable and conversely, that is how we have to construct. So, this problem can be boiled down to consider disjunction of laterals, some k lateral, let me say some n number of laterals, say L 1 or L 2 and so on, or say some L n, given a formula with this. If I can construct a formula f dash which is equivalent to this, in the sense that whenever this is satisfiable, this will be satisfiable and vice versa, and which has at most 3 laterals like this. Now, you see this will fit in 3 sat, because I am having at most 3 laterals here, all right. This will fit in 3 sat, and since these two are equivalent, now if you take any arbitrary formula, for an arbitrary formula also just simply you will replace the appropriate 3 sat instance, and then you can observe in a general case as well. So, what is the problem now? You are given a disjunction with some arbitrary number of laterals. You have to construct an instance of 3 sat such that the given formula f is equivalent to f dash. If you can do that, then we can see that satisfiability problem is reduced to 3 sat, but of course, this kind of thing if you can give straight forward construction which is independent of whatever that the laterals that you are constructing, then you see within this you can probably have this polynomial time reduction as well. So, by this technique, you can see that 3 satisfiability problem is NP complete. Now, if you ask for 4 satisfiability, you see you are allowed to have at most 4 laterals. Now, since 3 satisfiability problem is NP complete, now that problem is as hard as this problem, 3 satisfiability problem, and you can observe that k sat is NP complete for every k greater than or equal to 3. Now, the question is how to give this? How to give this? So, what you have to think that using these literals L 1, L 2, L n, you have to give me 3 laterals fitting here, at most 3, which is equivalent to this. Now, you can think of this, take this as an exercise to give this reduction, which works in polynomial time and an equivalent formula that you have to give. By giving this, you can observe this. All right. So, we can discuss some more NP complete problems, maybe now using the satisfiability problem or 3 sat. You just try this reducing satisfiability to 3 sat by just giving with this kind of information whatever I had given. Now, maybe we will reduce satisfiability problem or 3 satisfiability problems to many other optimization problems, the concerning what is called Dacian problems, concerning Dacian problems of many important satisfiability problems, optimization problems. And I will introduce in the next lecture few more problems which are NP complete and which are important in the literature. All right.